Hi and welcome to our channel. My name is Oleg Shevtsov and I'm head of PMD at PortaOne. In today's video, we are going to look at different considerations of HSS for an MVNO. Specifically, we are going to help you decide whether this mobile core element is a must-have or is just an extra cost for your MVNO, provided that you already have enough budget and decision whether you need to own your HSS or use the one provided by MNO. It's critical to do it now before you start your business. So first, what's an HSS? The home subscriber server is a database that stores subscriber-related information for a mobile network. It's a fundamental database for a mobile network ecosystem. Key functions of the HSS include authentication, authorization, and user profile management. It serves as a repository of SIM card data and essential user profiles. So, as an HSS, is a must-have or it's not a must-have? Let's consider the factors that include regulatory and roaming. Factors that you should consider include how much independence you want and whether you have or want an exit strategy. First, let's look deeper into those regulatory considerations. Some regulatory bodies may mandate MVNOs to have their own home subscriber server to ensure compliance with specific regulations. In order, for instance, to officially become an MVNO, you must have an HSS. But if you don't have HSS, you can still resell services under your own name and brand, but you will be called by government as a service provider, not an MVNO. Now let's explore how the presence of an HSS relates to your roaming considerations. Roaming is a critical aspect for MVNOs, especially when partnering with a mobile network operator. In some cases, an MVNO may require their own HSS if the MNO they partner with cannot or will not provide them with roaming services. Some MNOs will not offer this as a protection from competition. This adds complexity for MVNOs. For example, having own subscriber server becomes necessity to enable roaming services to your subscribers. This allows you to expand your coverage and offer seamless services when your subscribers are traveling to different regions. However, signing direct roaming agreement can be challenging for many, if not all MVNOs. Such negotiation complexities and limited opportunities for agreements with MNO abroad create a challenge. So MVNOs can opt for a multi-IMSI approach and providing services via roaming hubs. Typically, presence of an HSS facilitates the managers of these multi-IMSIs required for roaming hubs. So HSS can be vital in addressing these aspects related to roaming for your MVNO operations. Then bring us to more should consider factors, for instance, independence and exit strategies. By having your own home subscriber server, your MVNO gains more control over operations and reduces your dependencies on your host MNO. With the ability to manage the subscriber-related information independently from MNO, MVNO can offer unique services and tailor the offerings to meet specific needs of the target audience. This independence can offer significant competitive advantage comparing to other thin MVNOs. Moreover, HSS can be an essential part for the exit strategy. As an MVNO grows, you establish bigger subscriber base, and you can become a target for the acquisition from other MVNOs or maybe MNOs. The presence of an HSS makes it easier to transfer the subscriber base of the entire MVNO business to a different MNO or MVNO, streamlining the acquisition process and ensuring business continuity for subscribers. However, it is important to know that bringing in an HSS later, when your MVNO is operational, may present a huge challenge. One potential obstacle is the need of SIM card reissue and massive SIM swap for the subscribers. Therefore, considering the long-term goals and potential exit strategies from the outset can help MVNOs avoid complications and ensure seamless transition when the time comes. So, now the question whether you should use an HSS that is provided by your MNO. Just as with your own HSS, there are benefits of using the MNO-provided HSS. One significant advantage of relying on the MNO's HSS is decreasing the costs. MVNO may use the MNO's HSS, to refrain from buying HSS from third-party providers, and it results in the cost saving when establishing your MVNO business. Moreover, the maintenance of the HSS becomes more economical when it is administered by your MNO. The MNO already has well-versed day-to-day operations and managers of their HSS, and the processes related to, for instance, SIM issue, eSIM issue are much more smoother. So relying on the MNO's HSS is also a good alternative. The advantage lies in the established routines for SIM and eSIM issuing, and as MNO already has these processes, MVNO can benefit from smoother and more efficient system management for the subscriber base. This streamlined approach saves time and effort, allowing you to focus more on other aspects of your MVNO business. Relying on the MNO's HSS can be particularly beneficial for beginners, thin MVNOs, resellers just entering this industry, because it provides a straightforward entry point to the market, allowing newcomers to offer services quickly and with minimal expenses. A final consideration of that Owen HSS can bring you closer to becoming a full infrastructure MVNO when you grow. Here's an overview of the MVNO types, from reseller or service provider to enhanced provider and full infrastructure or thick MVNO. As you can see from the list of business processes, you can get closer to the full infrastructure MVNO if you purchase the HSS. Your business model gets more complex. Without HSS, you can't become a full MVNO. So, in summary, an HSS can be a necessity for an MVNO due to regulatory, roaming, and business factors. The benefits of having an HSS include flexibility, business security, and potential exit strategies. Whenever you use your MNO's HSS depends on the level of cooperation and competition between you as an MVNO and your MNO. MVNOs and thin resellers have succeeded without having their own HSS, using services of the host MNO or MVNE. And finally, having your own HSS positions you for easier growth later on. So, as you can see, having an HSS may be a necessity for your MVNO journey, depending on the future business plans. If your MNO is cooperative and your business plans do not involve rapid transformation towards complexity, you may not need one. So deciding whether you have an HSS is an important consideration that should be made in the beginning of your MVNO journey. Careful evaluation of regulatory requirements, business objectives, and the level of independence needed for an MVNO is critical in making the right choice from the very beginning. Now let me tell a little bit about PortaOne and what we do to help MVNOs succeed. We specialize in MVNO business model with open API tools and platforms that specifically designed for adaptability, deployment, providing you with top-notch experience and the best processes. We offer provisioning and workflow automation, a billing and online charging system, robust self-care portals for businesses, resellers, administrators, customers, and of course end users. And we offer tools like PortaOne OTT app for mobile. Thank you for watching. If you like this video content, I suggest you to subscribe to our channel. And if you have any questions regarding HSS or becoming an MVNO, please reach out to us. Thank you.